近日，南加州反对15号提案组织再次召开网络探讨会，呼吁民众积极投票阻止第15号提案通过。目前，加州及地方政府的机制无法实施分拆自用及商用地产税的制度，因此整个加州必须再雇佣900多个有经验的地产估值官。由于执行人员及机制的不足，加上实施新法的复杂程度，预计所需要的费用在头三年至少要10亿美元以上。
At the end of the day, it is the end users that will have to bear the tremendous amount of burden. We're looking at $11.5 billion annual tax increase. So that's the reason why the NAACP is out in, you know, urging people to vote against this bill, this proposition, because, you know, everybody is going to be impacted. It's not just the wealthy against the poor or the big corporations versus, you know, little guys. It is not that everybody is.
在随后的讨论中，来自南加州旅馆同业工会理事 Peter Sand 也向与会嘉宾发表了他的看法。
All people that own commercial property, regardless of the size of the property, your value will go down. Your value will go down, okay? Because you have a higher tax roll, therefore your net income is going to decrease. So if your net income decreases, when you try to sell your property, when someone else looks at it to buy it, it's always based on how much that property can produce after tax. And if your tax roll goes up and you cannot recoup 100% of it from your existing tenant because they simply cannot bear it, then what happens? Then the landlord also have to absorb the increase in tax, and he will soon realize his property value is going to dwindle down a lot.
主办方最后表示，在新冠疫情肆虐的背景下，加州财政短缺，但15号提案只是一个杀鸡取卵、十分短视的一个解决州政府财政不足的方案。它会对所有企业，包括中小型企业，造成雪上加霜的经济负担，不但无法真正的帮助到所有的加州的企业及居民，还会对所有的终端消费者带来物价上涨、生活成本及消费提高，最后的结果是无法解决财务问题之外，还会带来其他不良的后果。全美电视台记者采访。